That's who you are. We call you Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. That's who you are. Can we call him Jesus? We call you Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Call him faithful God. We call you faithful, 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 faithful. That's who you are. That's who you are, Lord. Let's call him again, faithful God. Who you are. Oh, we call you Father. You're a Father. Oh, you're a Father. That's who you are. Oh, you're Father. Oh, we call you Father. Bless the Lord. Oh. excellent is your name, oh God.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
my God,
my God, how excellent
is your name.
It's your name. My God,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
my God,
my God,
how excellent is your name,
is your name,
in
all
the earth,
how
excellent is your name,
oh Lord, my God,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
my God,
my God,
how excellent is your name,
is your name. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Heaven and earth adore Him. Angels bow before Him. What a serve a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
We serve a living God.
What a mighty God we serve.
Hallelujah.
Heaven and earth adore.
Oh, even angels bow. Jesus, how wonderful you are. You are brighter than the morning star. You are fairer, much fairer than the lily that grows by the way. You are precious, more precious than
Father, we thank you for this occasion that you, the Lord, has ordained today. As it is written in your word, that in everything we should give thanks, for this is the will of God concerning us in Christ Jesus. And so, Father, we thank you for making this day possible. At the beginning of this service, we committed into your hands, and we ask, Lord, that you would take absolute control from the very beginning to the very end in the name of Jesus. We pray, O Lord, that at the end of it all, your name and your name alone will be glorified in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, that you, the God of all comfort, will comfort as many who are mourning on this occasion in the name of Jesus. We pray, O Lord, that you will wipe every tear and you will encourage the weary. Thank you, Father, for hearing our prayer. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise God. We shall remain standing while we sing the first hymn. first hymn is in the program that we have with us, page 4. When peace like a river.
It is well But Lord, it is for thee, for thy coming we wait. The sky, not the grave, is our goal. O trump of the angel, O voice.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Well, welcome to this funeral service for our sister, our mother, Oromoke Adebo. Our prayer to Dipo and the kids, to the Adebo family, the Olugbodi family, the friends, colleagues, and everyone who is gathered here today, is that the Holy Spirit will comfort us in Jesus' name. We will be going to the reading, the first Bible reading, and I would like to call Damola Adebo to take the first Bible reading.
First Bible reading, 1 Thessalonians 4:13-18. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who are falling asleep, lest you sorrow as others have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore comfort each other with his words.
Remain on our seat as we sing the second hymn, Jerusalem on High. Thank you.
to see thy face. The patriarchs of old, they're from the troubled seas. The prophets they behold, they longed for Prince of Peace. When shall I be, my God, with thee to see thy face? The Lamb's apostles there, I might with joy behold. The harpers I might hear, harping on harps of gold.
Oh, happy place, when shall I be, my God, with thee to see thy
bleeding martyrs they within those courts are found, clothed in pure array, their scars with glory crowned. Oh, happy place, when shall I be, my God, with thee to see thy. Ah, woe is me that I in Kedar stands this day. No place like that on high, Lord, thither guide my way. Oh, happy place, when shall I be, my God, with thee to see thy face?
Taking the second Bible reading, Oyinka Olubodi will take the Bible reading.
We'll be reading from Matthew 25:11-13. Afterward, the other vendors came also saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, assuredly, I say to you, I do not know who you are. Watch therefore, for you don't know, you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming. Okay.
Yes, so we will be going straight to the first set of tributes. Before the tributes, I'd like to just recognize some of our pastors and reverends who are here. Reverend Sunday Oladejo from the Triumphant Baptist Church is here. You're welcome, sir. Reverend Dr. Matthew Shinyobade from the Living Spring Baptist Church is here. You're welcome, sir. Reverend Ayodeji Ayokbo, Triumphant Baptist Church, is also here. And of course, Reverend Oluwole Adeleko is also here, so you're welcome. God bless you. We would go to the first set of tributes. This tribute, we have three people. Please would like you to take about 2 minutes each. The first is Adeolu and Dotun. And after Adeolu and Dotun, we'll take Kola Olugodi. And after Kola, we'll take Adebusola Adebo. So in that order, Adeolu and Dotun can please come forward to take the to read the tribute.
My mom is a very nice woman. She always provided me and my family with what we needed. She always picked me from school and her food was delicious. She always organized the best birthdays for our family. And anytime we travel, she always buys us clothes and shoes. Anytime we have any struggle in the family, my mom always knows the solution to it. She was making a lot of money from our events. And she was a hardworking woman who tries her best to provide for the family. She was aiming to be the best at events planning and whatever she loves. And I always tell her that her jollof rice was the best, that she should go for a cooking competition. Every time I think of my mom, I always remember myself because my dad always says I look like her. My mom made me the best dance birthday party of my life. It was literally a banger. And I think that was the best birthday party in my school that people attended. I really appreciate what my mom did for me all through my life. She has been chosen to manage events for a lot of big companies like Stanbic, First Bank. She also offered to decorate one of the best schools in Nigeria, James Hope College, and was given lots of money. My mom was very excited. They loved what she did and was expecting to do another one this year. But because of COVID-19, she wasn't able to do. My dad's sisters and brothers also liked my mom for being a nice woman. My mom loved Jesus. My mom loved Jesus because of herself, normally and mostly because of my grandma, who has 8 children and few of them are pastors. My grandma likes people to preach the word of God. I will forever miss my mom, no matter what happens, and may her soul rest in peace.
Dear Mom, I miss you so much. I wish I could talk to you again. Dear Mom, I miss you so much. I wish I could see you. I don't know how long we are going to go abroad again, but I'm sure Daddy will try to make it happen. Daddy told me that when he was praying and crying, you told him to stop crying and just pray normally. He also told me you still wanted to look beautiful when you were sick, and I wish I could see you in heaven. About 80 people have come to the house because you died, and nobody will replace you. As your son, I miss you so much, but I'm trying not to cry because I might say something bad. I love you, Mom.
Praise the Lord. All right, RMK. She was always in our garden. Brakola, I'm afraid, though, all this happening all over the world. I hope the rapture is not about to happen. Hey, so what can one do to be sure to make heaven? We all just need to be sure that we are in Christ and also keep our relationship with Him and God intact, was my response. Emma, if you're all on Bewawo. This was the discussion Romoke and I had when the coronavirus broke out across the globe. Though I knew that she was born again, my heart really went out to her that day because I knew that she really wanted to ensure that, come what may, she makes it to heaven. I never knew that she just wanted to be sure that she gets back to her Creator when her individual rapture occurred the night of August 9, 2020. Baba, as she fondly calls me, Aloro, was a statement I get from my darling sister from time to time. After most of our gist together, our concluding statement was often, Melulaye. And that means there is not much to this world. That's one of the statements that my younger sister says so much. It has really been tough for me losing my dearest and one and only sister, Romoke. She was the last born of the family, and she brought so much joy and stability to the family. I sincerely longed for a sister, and when she eventually came, she was loved from day one. I was ready to do anything to protect and make life worthwhile for Romoke. I was a nanny. I would wash her nappies and place her on my back joyfully anytime she wanted to sleep. Wow. All right. As we used to play when we were children, that's the time we used to say, who is in the garden? A little small boy. Can I come and see her or him? No, 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 follow me. And then somebody else gets inside the circle. In real life, for the Olugbodi siblings, only one person was in our circle. And that was Romoke. She was permanently in that circle. She was ever in the circle, the center of the garden, and the eight brothers permanently surrounded and danced around her. RNK was always focused. She always knew what to do per time. She was always hardworking, always loving, always generous, and ever creative and innovative. She was the prettiest and always full of life, yet very humble, humorous, and glamorous. For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Her solace is that she knew the Lord and loved Him dearly. She's always with Him. Of course, this last Ileya, they were in Abeokuta. And he came to you. And she said, we were going to see. But somehow we could not see. She wanted us to discuss. She had some things in her mind. She wanted us to discuss. We could not see. They will see. Thank you.
These are your words, now imprinted in the frame of my mind forever. You taught me to live in the moment, for you knew the moment you are sharing with us will become memories in a short while. Mopsi will fulfill her promise to you. Ramake, you were able to crack my code in spite of my walls, because you know I was a very private person. But you came into my world and you became one of us. We have all come to trust and rely on you because you have proven yourself a worthy daughter to my mother and a true sister to us all. You have proven yourself a worthy and true friend to me. In my most vulnerable time, through it all, me was the most important factor to you. PP, no doubt yourself. You have planned photo shoots for many years for me, because you know those things doesn't really matter to me. 1st of August in Abeokuta, you still shared pictures with me of what the photo shoots will look like, what my daughter should wear, what I should wear. You're truly on a mission to create so much memories, not just for yourself, but for all your loved ones. Your mother-in-law would never forget you because she did not come into our family to divide us. Rather, you became a unifying factor, always love and peace, always your husband's advocate. Your words were, please forgive my husband. My heart is shattered, but I know the light you have brought into our lives in your memories will continue to help us heal and get through this very, very tough time. I loved you then, I love you now, and I'll love you always. Adobusola Adebo, Yalaje, the title you gave me.
Once more, the prayer. Our prayer is that the Holy Spirit will comfort each and every one of us in Jesus' name. There are certain songs that Ramoke liked when she was here with us, and we're going to invite DJ Sax to play one of those songs in memory of Ramoke. quickly go to the second set of tributes, taking 2 minutes each. Dami Lola, Mr. Shino, Fun Lola, and Odunwayo, in that order.
Tribute to my president, my mama, the absolute love of my life, and to Ramoke, my RMK, my best friend, my auntie, my lover, my support system, my mentor, my boss, my indulger. If I'm to go on, I'll run out of descriptions, because with you I was my best. With you I felt homely, with you I felt babied, with you I felt like the best thing in the world. I honestly can't believe I'm having to do this. I mean, this should have been me writing you epistles on your birthdays and the days that I remember how much you mean to me. Right now, I'm finding it so hard to put words together. MK, this wasn't the plan. I wish tears could bring you back. We've all cried so much, and we'll do more if it could bring you back to us. I've been hoping to wake up from this nightmare, hoping you'll come back and tell me that it's a surprise. I can't believe I won't wake up to your messages anymore. No one to tell me, Damlala, I like this clothes, what do you think? No one to hype me for doing the most basic things. You believed in me so much, even more than I believed in myself, and you always made me realize that there was no level I couldn't attain. I honestly wish you didn't leave. I wish it wasn't your pictures everywhere with the condolence messages. My heart has been so heavy. Your funny Damlala isn't finding this funny. The house feels so empty, even with so many people in it. I don't know what to do. I wish you were here so that you could answer all my questions. But in all of this, it gives me joy that I know that you're in heaven. Even here on earth, you were a gem. You were an amazing person. You were a light. You showed everyone that came across you so much love. You touched lives. You gave hope and always made us realize that there were better ways to handle situations and people. Continue to rest in the bosom of the Lord, my queen. I know the angels are glad to receive a fashionista in their midst. Till we meet again, my fave, I'll continue to celebrate you. I'll continue to strive to make you proud, like we always discussed. Thank you for being a light. Thank you for being my mother. I love you forever.
Good night, dear friend. I will miss our very random conversations that always ended with you telling me a new thing you have discovered. And yes, I now shop at Price Point. I can see your face as I write, always shining with a glowing smile like the summer sunrise. You are a true blessing. Always ready to listen.
and you'd laugh so heartily. A strong, positive, and certain woman. A powerful respect and warmth in every encounter with you. Thank you for teaching us how to live. Thank you for being a good friend. Thank you for living a life of purpose, a life so simple and yet so true. Moromoke Adebo, truly beautiful in and out. Rest in peace, dearest RMK. Amen.
Queen departs, a queen, that is who you are. So much grace, so much beauty, so much wisdom. Gosh, you are so brilliant. I tease you on how you manage it all with so much poise and grace, and how you will still wear heels on your way to the labor room. You exuded so much light and love to all around you. You just had to let everyone have a glimpse of you. Every day of my life, everything in my life, everything around you has you attached to it or has your name written on it. You are such a blessing to me, my elder sister. You loved me so much, caring for me every step of the way, loving my son like yours. I don't tell you how much I love you, honestly. I wish I took more pictures with you. I wish I spent more time with you in the hospital. After crying, I choose to remember all the beautiful memories we built together. Smile when I hear your voice telling me what to do and how to go about work. Telling me to process. Calling me your external brain. Sequoia, Sequoia. Alpha, Kilo Shell. So much memories, RMK. So much. Thank you for making me strong. Thank you for challenging me. Thank you for caring for me. Thank you for being thoughtful. Thank you for teaching me to go the extra mile. Thank you for teaching me how to make every memory count. The shoe you have left for us to feel, just like your heels, is too big, is too beautiful, and is too high. I will miss you so much. I really do not know how I will live every single day of my life without you.
Amen. We're going to be taking the next hymn now. Standing. Please, let's rise on our feet.
My best friend, Romoke Adebo. We've been best friends for many years. You've always been there for me, through tears and fears. You never forsake me. You were not just a friend, but a sister. You've always been the best in me. You've always saw the best in me. My heart still aches in sadness. And secret tears still flow, what it means to lose you, no one can ever know. I pray to you today, a hollow in my heart is where you always stay. Sunre Oremi, Sunre, my body of life, Odigbere. Boromoke did something very painful to me. She told me everything about herself. She called me her external memory card. But one thing she didn't do to me, she didn't tell me this. She did not tell me this. But I still wonder why she did not tell me this.
Take the next hymn now, the third hymn, Because He Lives. Please, let's rise on our feet. Cross the river, I'll
fight lies fight. Now war with pain, and then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the light of glory, and I'll know.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I believe that the hymns that we've heard today, the words we've heard, have already ministered to us. And it's touched our lives, especially for those of us who knew Romoke when he was on this side. Particularly in the very first one we sang, which, you know, at events like this, the words of those hymns tend to witness to us directly. We're talking about when peace like a river. Sometimes that indeed sorrows roll like sea billows. But whatever my lot may be, the Bible has assured us that it is well with my soul. That is the word that was brought to you this afternoon, that whatsoever the wind, whatsoever, no matter how boisterous the wind may be, no matter how sad our souls may be, it is well with your soul. It is well with our soul. That expression is a prayer. It is an assurance of faith. It is an assurance. It is not an empty cliche. There are certain words of God that are spoken from time to time that sometimes we take them for granted. When someone says, God bless you, it's become so commonplace that you don't know that it is still a prayer. God bless you. Amen. Therefore, when we say it is well, it is a prayer. Because no matter what lies ahead of you, the family, the immediate family, and every other person, friends, business, colleagues, and the rest of them, just have that assurance that it is well in Jesus' name. In 2 Kings chapter 4, there was a story that the Bible tells us, and speaking about a prophet, Elisha, and a woman that is now known popularly as the Shunammite woman. In that scripture, the Bible records that Elisha and his protege would go through this certain place in Shunem each time. And there was a particular woman who was kind. The Bible actually describes that woman as a great woman. The woman was kind, was hospitable, was nice, and every other thing. And because of the hospitality and everything that she did, Elisha decided to, just as the Spirit ministered to him, to do something for this woman. The woman had no child, and then Elisha spoke the word of God, ministered to the woman, and the woman then had a child. But that was not the end of the story. The Bible records that shortly after, the child died. And if you go with me to particularly chapter 26 to 28, so the child died, and when the child died, the Bible recorded that the woman then went to Elisha. So looking at 2 Kings, yes, chapter, yes. So the woman, the Bible records that the child died, the miracle child died. And after the miracle child died, the woman had a good sense to go to the God and the representative of that God who gave the child. And the Bible records from verse 26 of 2 Kings chapter 4 that the woman started to come towards Elisha. And Elisha says to the servant, run now, I pray thee, to meet her and say unto her, is it well with thee? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with the child? And she answered, it is well. And verse 27, and when she came to the man of God to the hill, she caught him by the feet. But Gehazi came near to thrust her away, and the man of God said, leave her alone, for her soul is vexed within her, and the Lord had done what? Had hid it from me, and had not told me. And then the woman went on to complain about what had happened. A few things from this scripture. This woman was in deep pain from losing someone who was very, very close to her, a child. But no matter how painful, no matter how deep that pain was, when Gehazi was asking her, is it well with you? She says, it is well with me. The second thing is that, as the prophet said, it was not shown to me. I didn't know that this was going to happen. So sometimes, as we've seen in this case, sometimes God does surprise us. He surprises us. Sometimes we continue to ask him why. Why? Why, Romoke? Why now? Why this? Why, and why? But Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 29, explains that very clearly, because indeed, it is not every question that we ask on this side. It's not for every question that we ask that we get an answer. 29:29, Deuteronomy says, the secret things belong unto the Lord our God, but those things which are revealed belong unto us and to our children forever, that we may all do what? Do the words of this law. So sometimes he may choose to tell us why, but sometimes he may not tell us why. But I can assure you that there is something that you always have to revert to, even when you don't know why, and that is the principles of God. The certain things that God does consistently and what he has said, and you can find the answer in those principles. And some of those principles is what I'll just reel through this morning to give you an assurance. First is that God is always good. So whatever has happened to our sister, understand that God is always good. Psalm 34 verse 8 says, taste and see that the Lord is good, and blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. Always good. That is God. Second principle is that his plans towards his people are always good. His thoughts towards us are good. Always good. So whatever it is that happens, we must look at it from that perspective of the principles of God, which is, first, God is good. Two, whatever it is, that it is always for our good, because his thoughts for us are always for good. A third principle, which is very important for all of us, is that indeed, no matter how long we live in this earth, our life is like a trailer in a movie. You don't shoot a trailer and then you say, I'm not going to shoot the movie. The movie is the real intent. The trailer is just an introduction to the movie. So life is a trailer. eternity is the real movie. Because eternity is really the reason why we're living life. Life is a rehearsal. The play and the performance is in eternity. So no matter how long we live on this side of life, we must always be conscious that this is just a rehearsal. Eternity is still on the other side. If you're someone who watches football and understands, again, I say that life is, you know, when you are in life, is like God has lent you to this world, right? So, you know, when a player is on loan, go on loan, you must go back to your club one way or the other. So God has lent all of us to this world, and we are going to return to our original club, no matter how long we are on this loan. So, but it is very critical and important that we use the time we have here very well. My sister, from what we've heard from the testimonies and everything, it was almost like she was in a hurry to really, really leave a mark on this life. It was almost like she had a foreboding that she wasn't going to have 100 years, so let me do what God has sent me to do. And that is very, very critical and very important. Because at the end of the day, what you are going to carry with you is the content of what you do here. What you're going to carry with you is the content of each day that you live. How many people did you touch? How many lives did you touch? It's not about how many cars you had, how many houses you built, how many, you know, and so on and so forth. It's about, how did you fulfill the mission that God gave you on this earth? And as far as we can read from Romoke's life, it is very, very, it is self-explicit that she lived life. Saw some of the pictures where she was reaching out to old people, saw some of the pictures where she was doing her outreach, and so on and so forth. And then you begin to think, how would such a young person have such wisdom to do all those things that would not matter to someone else? So indeed, it's very, very important that we have that understanding that for all of us, this is just a short time, and the time is coming on the other side. The other principle is that, yes, we are mourning on earth. Yes, we are crying on earth. We are asking all this on earth. But it is not the same in heaven. It is not the same in heaven. Because Psalm 116 verse 15 says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. What does that mean? So when we are mourning on earth, it means heaven is rejoicing. Amen. Now, what a paradox. That we are crying and we are mourning and we're doing all of that, but the owner of life, the one who gave our own loan, that has taken our back, is rejoicing, because precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of the righteous, yes, of the saints. So it's also important for us to know that whatsoever it is, Isaiah 23:15 says that the Lord taketh the righteous away from the days of evil. That is what he does in his own wisdom and in his own understanding. He does that. Amen. And finally, that indeed, death is a debt that we are all going to pay. Everybody will pay that. Romoke has paid that debt. She's on the other side. She's not experiencing any pain anymore. She has gone to be with the Lord. I wish we could see the joy on that other side. I wish that the Lord will open your eyes to see that. And I believe that at the end of the day, as you catch that vision, then your mind will settle a bit and you'll start thinking more about yourself than about her. Because she has done the work that God has given her to do. She has fought the battle. She has done everything and she has gone to rest. So a question to you is that, how are you walking towards that time of rest? Romoke's life was filled with rich content. You could see she helped people. She brought joy to people. She was fervent. She was urgent. She was always capturing memories. She had presence. And you know, we would always remember her with those beautiful memories which she insisted that she would capture. The Bible, in closing, talks about a story in Acts chapter 9, verse 36, about a lady called Tabitha or Dorcas. And he says that when the lady died, the Bible says she was full of works and alms deeds, which she did. So much so that the community went and ran to Peter and said, no, you can't allow this one to die. Look at all the work that she did when she was here. And then Peter had to come, and then Tabitha got another chance. I believe that for each and every one of us, we're getting another, any time that we're confronted with the word of God is giving us another chance. Amen. It's giving us another chance. It's not to sow fear, but it's just to say that in life, if you don't understand, especially with what we're seeing recently, that you better leave your life packed, fully packed, ready, as in your bag is ready to move, because we don't know what time God is going to call. I would like to give us an assurance, families, that indeed our sister has gone to be with the Lord. She's resting. Let us hold our memories in great esteem. Let's remember her for all the things that God used her to do. Let's remember her for the way she touched our lives. And let us, in the spirit of that, live our lives in that way. Let us do everything that God has packed into us to do. And whatever it is that is in our hands, which is not in consonance with the word of God, it is important that we drop it. Nobody promised us tomorrow. Nobody promised us tomorrow. My prayer is that the Lord will keep the children, but the Lord will keep you strong, the Holy Spirit will strengthen you, he will keep the families, and that as we leave this place, we'll not live like those who just forgot that something happened. Because it's very easy in human life and the way God made us that when something happens, we just move on. Amen. But as you move on, just remember that there's someone who is counting the calendar, and unfortunately, he's not going to tell you when he's going to come. It's not going to tell me when it's going to come. Amen. Let us close our eyes. And I want you to just say a word of prayer. I want you to thank God because he is good. I want you to thank him because he is good. I want you to thank him because his plans for us are always good. I want us to thank him because he knows. I want us to thank him because he's the all-knowing God. I want you to thank him for the life that he has enabled his daughter to live, for the way that she's touched each and every one of us who is here, physically or remotely. Let us thank him for the opportunity to cross our path. And I want you to speak to him if you are here and you don't know him and you want to, or you'll be postponing and postponing. I want you to use this great opportunity to speak to him. Very simple, just ask, tell him, God, I give my life to you today because I know that it can be any time. It can be any time. I pray that when death comes, you will be ready. I will be ready. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. I would like to call Reverend Adelekan to pray for the family.
I would like the husband and the kids to please rise up on their feet as we pray. Shall we pray together? Father, in the name of Jesus, to thee, O Father, we give thanks. We bless your holy name because there is no one like you. We bring our heart of gratitude because there is no one like you. Let all men be liars. Father, you are still faithful. We worship your majesty, and we still testify that you are awesome. You are wonderful, and you are mighty. Thank you, Father, for the word that you have sent to us. Thank you for the word of comfort. Thank you for the word of hope. Thank you because of who you are. You are mighty in battle. You are ancient of days. We honor your majesty and we confess that you, O God, you own our lives. Forever we will continue to worship you no matter what happens. Your sovereignty and your lordship testify that is no one to be compared to you. You are God. Father, be exalted in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, you said in your word, in your wisdom, the Bible says, a good name is better than a precious perfume, and the day of death is better than the day of birth. The Bible even says that it is good to go to the house of mourning than the house of feasting. For that is the end of every man. And every living soul will lay it upon their heart. Father, we thank you for bringing us together for this occasion. We give thanks to you, Lord, for your daughter that you have recalled back home. For giving her grace and virtue to secure a good name. Father, be glorified in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the tool that you have given unto her to do, touching lives, healing wounds, deliver souls, bless lives, raising those that are down and lifting those that are helpless. Thank you, Father, for every testimony. We bless your name. Father, be glorified in the name of Jesus. To thee, Jehovah, we lift up our voices now. In a time like this, Father, we need you more. Especially our husband and the children. Lord, to our husband, I pray that you will give unto him grace to continue in life and to fulfill in the name of Jesus. And for the children to live, to grow, and to be great in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For the siblings of Olubodi and the Adibos, that you give them grace, O God, to understand the purpose behind this. That they may rejoice in you despite all us in the mighty name of Jesus. For the aged parent, that will make them strong in the name of Jesus. For friends and colleagues, Lord, I pray that you will use the testimony of your daughter to touch every of our lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Even for your church, we will continue to rejoice in you. In the name of Jesus. Heaven over the family of Adebo, you will not be shut up. In the name of Jesus. And the Lord Jehovah will grant unto the family of Olubodi joy, strength, grace, and life. Thank you, Father. You have done this. And we celebrate you. Romanka, you do not want us to cry and to weep for you, but to rejoice and to celebrate you. And this is what we are doing. Celebrating you at death. You live forever. Glory to the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.
We're on the program now where there's a foundation that is going to be unveiled in memory of Romoke, and I'd like to call Segilola Alex Ajayi to lead this portion.
You have not lived today until you have done something for someone who can never repay you. We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. RMK made a life by giving. She had a passion for giving. She derived joy in seeing people happy. She gave effortlessly, never weary of giving. Not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with love. In our own little way, she made impact. She made people experience love. She showed love to those who didn't have love in Dustbin Village. She gave a wonderful Christmas experience to over 500 children. Games, food, music, gifts. It was an amazing time. She showed love on the streets, love and dirt. She went out on the road to appreciate our Lagos road workers for risking their lives to keep Lagos road clean, providing them raw food and car fabrics and just generally having fun with them on Valentine's Day and showing them love. She showed love to the elderly ones at the old people's home. She dined with the elderly in the old people's home on Valentine's Day. We had premium meals set up, delivered medical supplies, bed sheets, adult diapers, and so forth. She showed love to the vulnerable, Shop for a Cause. At Shop for a Cause, she had a sales set up of her pre-loved and new clothes. And all the proceeds from the sales went to providing school kits and accessories to public school kids. Giving is not just about making a donation. It's about making a difference. Join us today to make a difference.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place is much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough. Care.
Thank you. I will call on Mr. Oladipo Adebo to come on stage, and Mr. Tunji Olubudi. Also, Mr. Dele Adiaga.
Mr. Dele Adiaga, please. Okay, just a few words from me. Thank you. All the pictures and the videos that you've seen regarding my wife with her charity work, you won't see a picture of me in there, you won't see a video of me. Not because I didn't support her, I would rather support from the back end. It's so unfortunate. We'll have to support from the front end now. And we'll have the honor and privilege of Mr. Dele Adiaga to help us launch the charity organization. Hallelujah. Let me first say it's a privilege to be here. And it's also a privilege to have known her and know what she stood for in her life. As written there, RMK lives on. Anything in our life that we can hold, they are temporal. What really matters are the things that we can see, and that's what she left behind. She left a mark in every one of us gathered here today, and as many as are following us on social media. We will never forget her because she made an impact in 38 years of life. The reason she lived the way she did is because of two things. She loved God with all her heart, all her mind, and all her substance. And the second one, she loved people. And that's why she did all the things she did. And shame on us if we allow the values she believed in to die. And that's why I'm standing here, because I believe in this cause. There's going to be a lot of information that will be circulated on what and how we can support this. But for this moment, if you believe in this and you want to support this, let me see your hands up. God bless you. We are more than enough to make her dream continue, and it will continue. I would also like to ask one person to join us here as we do the unveiling of Romoke Olubodi Adebo Foundation. I would like to call Mr. Lanre Ojo Aromakudu to join us here. The four of us standing here, we will do our best to ensure that this dream does not die. I've seen lots of foundations started, and 1 year, 2 years after, they're done. This one will not be like that. It will be a legacy that will stand forever. And God will help us to deliver on this unveiling that we are doing today. Thank you so much. So if you can join me, we unveil RMK Olubodi Adebo Foundation to the glory of the Father, for the benefit of humanity, especially the less privileged among us, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you so much. God bless you.
We'll go to the vote of thanks. Deepa, you're giving the vote of thanks. Praise the Lord. Before I proceed to the vote of thanks, I would like to say a word or two about my wife. It's unfortunate that I'm doing this. I thought the next time I was going to talk about my wife would be when she clocks 40, which will have been next year, December 2nd. It's challenging, it's difficult, but the beat goes on. My love, we discuss why more matured and less matured couples are having relationship trouble, and we kept wondering if what they share is what we shared. Ours was romance made in heaven and executed on earth. It was love that cuts across all barriers, and looking back, I now know you were an angel sent to minister to me. Our story started back when you were 19 years and I 23 years, and that was based on pure and undiluted love. There was nothing to offer you other than few love cards and the whole of me anyway. I recall how whenever you finished your class early, you would come over to mine to wait for me so we can leave campus together. We had dreams, and we gradually built the little success we now have, one day at a time, yet aiming for the moon. Recently, you told me that you needed us to share our secret of success in relationship management on Instagram Live with an audience, which we did, and our secret was communication. We were living off campus in school, and whenever you came visiting, what we did was chased. Yaomi, you turned me to amebo as we discussed everything to everything. Fast forward 20 years into our relationship, and what still held us together was our special type of gist. Some of our gist I would have to share. Some of our high-level gist, including you asking me whenever I go on a long-haul travel, the 9 hours, the 12 hours travel of this world, and you ask me, what babe did he assign next to you on the plane? Well, I don't know if it's by heaven's design. I've always been attached to men or elderly women, and when the lady is even young, she's pregnant. And I will send you a discreet picture whenever I'm on a plane so you see the person attached to me. And your response was always, Dipo, oh, Lori Omo. Such was our gist. Our gist was without boundary. When there's a trending news on politics, you will ask me to break it down for you because politics was never your thing. When I bring up gist of a church and the latest happenings around it, you ask me you are not interested. So we don't offend God, and we just carry on with the social media gist.
I remember you fondly, I remember your fondly phrase of Mafi Fekwami, whenever I show you some acts of love. You gave me space without choking me with love. Yet your presence I felt everywhere. Whenever I'm with my friends and you call, and I tell you I'm hanging out with the boys, your response was always, Sha Moon Combo. So for me, it's always bringing something back, whether it is fish, whether it is asun, or whatever we were dining with. Few times we have had reasons to have disagreements, but our marriage was never on the table for discussion. Now, to the real you, work ethics. I've said this many, many times, even while you were alive. I said, if I have your ability for work, if I have the stamina for hard work like you did, I'll either be a Dangote or I'm down with terminal illness. And I'm not kidding about that. It's not lip service here. I was raised by a hard-working single mom that cared for four kids on her own. So I recognize hard work when I see one. But yours was on a different level. How I know you have a pending brief, to execute is if while you we are at sleep and my body touches yours, it seems you're having fever because your temperature will be high to the touch. And that shows while you are asleep, your brain wasn't sleeping. Eye for excellence. It's never nice enough for you. Even when I try a few times to lay our bed and I'll go like my side of the bed is good enough, you are never happy. You go like, you wake me up so that the bed can be relayed. You will never accept mediocrity and you will make sure that the bed is properly laid before we sleep. And such was your eye for excellence. You carry the same high level of perfection to deliver excellent results for your clients, and no wonder the big brands in country can't have enough of you. I always told you that you were the best event corporate planner in country, and heavens know I wasn't trying to psych you up. I was telling you the very truth because I know. When it comes to business acumen, you claim that you are a market woman. However, I always relied on your market woman ideology in my own business and investments before I commit to any venture. You were my first go-to person. The few times I've gone against your advice, I got my fingers burnt. Beauty personified. Yahoo may find the God here. Black, ebony and shining. Let me reveal one of your secrets. Even while in Osbomo shop that is prone to heavy amatan, you have never used a body cream. Yet you never stopped glowing. You were a mother hen. This one seems to be too much as you dotted all over me and the kids. The way a mother hen dots around its chicks and protects them from talons of a hawk. I'm just wondering if you surrendered yourself to the hawk of this world rather than the hawk taking any of your chicks, with me being the biggest chick you have. You were a prayer warrior. I now recall how many times you told me that Jesus is coming back and you were afraid. And in my typical joking manner, I always tell you, Jesus cannot come now.
Jesus cannot come now because I felt this was our own time. How wrong I was. When you kept on insisting, I said, I just saw Pastor Adeboye on the screen. I saw Pastor Bakari. I saw Bishop Oyedepo. So if those guys are still around, well, that means nothing has happened. And if not something has happened and those guys are still around, then it's not sure for anyone. So let's just all stay here. You kept on insisting and you had to talk to your brother about it. While on your sick bed and fighting for your life, you kept on assuring me that you will make it out and there will be a big Thanksgiving celebration. That instant, love, I will break the bank for us to have a grand celebration. In so much discomfort, an oxygen mask over your nose, the only word of prayer you kept on repeating was, Jesus shall know me. Your continuous cry for mercy unto the Lord resonates in my ears every time, and I doubt it will ever go away. Glam champion. On your deathbed, you still insisted I bring your shining slippers. And I was like, shining slippers, look on. Your strength was making a 1,000 naira spend look like $1,000. And your courage complemented that. You were a picture addict. It seems the reason we had technology advance from the Kodak cameras to the digital cameras we have today is because of you. For every dress you had on, you had minimum of 30 pictures. And how harrowing was it for me whenever we vacation, because I was a photographer. So when we go out, typically in a day, I take 100 pictures, 150 pictures. How I wish you will stay so I can take more of those pictures. You're a vacation mama. Nothing made you happier, and it was your dream to see a minimum of 70 countries. Recently, I was sharing with a friend that whatever my wife does for me, I will forgive her, irrespective. And that's because I'm selfish. And my friend wondered what I meant by being selfish. I'm selfish because I know that without you, I can't go on. So the best I could do was forgive you, even if you offend me of the gravest sins. You never did, never had a reason for me to forgive you for anything. Most of our quarrels was about me wanting to watch football, you wanting to watch something else. It was about me wanting to watch action movie and you wanting to watch romance movie. And you insisted that we must share the TV. So that's one of the issues we had. So it was never, ever anything major. Romoke, I'm sure you know the love I have for you runs so, so deep that I would forgive anything that you would ever do to me. But this sin of leaving me that you have committed is too deep for me to forgive. Post-surgery, I was prepared to do all it takes and nurture you back to full recovery. That was not meant to be. So the dedication I would have used in nurturing you to full term, if you had pulled through your procedure, I would divert on our children to see they grow into strong men with admirable personalities. I know what you will wish for more than anything is that our kids love the Lord, and I will do my very best to show them the path of the Lord. I do, my angel. I'm keeping to my promise of forgiving you, irrespective. So I forgive you for this sin of leaving me. Go in peace. And I also would like to seize the opportunity to thank, firstly, the Olubodi family. They entrusted the best thing in the Olubodi family in my care. But that's what I was there for me before. And I tried. I did all I could to keep her. I loved her, I nurtured her. She wouldn't stay. I also would like to thank the pastorate of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Solid Rock. We've been attending the church for 14 years now. And typical loss, we decided to remain anonymous. And I was pleasantly surprised receiving a call from Pastor Yinka telling me that they will be glad to anchor the program, Pastor Yinka and the entire pastorate of Redeemed Christian Church of God. I really appreciate you. I would also like to thank all my wife's customers. You guys supported her in every way. You made her who she was. You gave her succor. You gave her fulfillment. You gave her purpose. You made her dream come true. So I'd like to thank you. I'd like to thank First Bank. I'd like to thank Stanbic Bank. I'd like to thank Wema Bank. I'd like to thank Bank of Industries. I'd like to thank Wando, all her customers. I'm sorry if you're a client here to Epicenter and somehow I missed your name. I'm really sorry about that. I also would like to thank my family members. They've been my support system. They've supported me at this trying time. And lastly, the Yorubas say, Igba Ikmojula Amore. I never knew I had good friends around. So I'd like to thank my friends. Some of them are much more older. Some of them are younger. Some of them typically were age mates. They came through for me, supported me immensely. I really appreciate you. My prayer is that we won't have a reason to do this in a long, long time. Thank you very much, everybody.
Pradipo, our prayers are with you. The God who can comfort the broken heart. He will be your comforter continually in Jesus' name. The pain that cannot be healed by medicine, God can handle them. So our prayers are with you. We believe you come out of these stronger and still live to fulfill the rest of your days, even in joy. In the name of Jesus. We appreciate everyone that came. We thank you for honoring the memory of our beloved sister. We're grateful for the time that we've spent. We're bringing the service to a close now. So we're going to proceed to the final place of interment. Because of the safety protocols and government regulations regarding us, interment purposes, we have limited number of people who will proceed to where our sister will be finally laid to rest. The order in which we'll go, we'll allow the ministers to go first, followed by the family, and then the cops will go follow us to the place of interment. We have just 20 numbers only allowed to be at the interment venue. Please kindly bear with us. Shall we rise, please, to bring the service to a close? Let's say a word of appreciation to God for this privilege. It's a difficult time, but we are grateful for how far He has helped us. And let's pray once again for the family, that the Lord will stand by them and strengthen them, even in this season, to still have reason to rejoice again. And in this family, evil will not arise any longer. Father, we're grateful. Lord, as we go, we ask, Lord, that you go with us. The remaining part of the program, Father, you conclude successfully. Of as many who have traveled from far and wide, Father, we pray that you grant us journey mercies back. Take all the glory, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. The grace and fellowship. The ministers will go first, followed by the family, and then we have the cops join us. Thank you.